Now let's move on to another of the day's stories we're following here, and this is Yemen, a country bordering with Saudi Arabia, one of the world's richest economies, has suffered for many years from extreme poverty, high rates of unemployment and severe malnutrition among its children. Well, today Yemen is in the throes of an armed conflict that's made the humanitarian crisis much worse. A coalition led by Saudi Arabia is currently bombing the country in a bid to oust Shia Houthi rebels who took over Sana'a and forced President Hadi into exile. As a result of that fighting, 1 million people are now displaced, 16 million don't have access to drinking water, and the number of hungry people is growing. Well, joining us on the phone from Amman in Jordan is Mohamed Suleiman, who's a food security expert with the UN's Food and Agriculture Organization. Very good day to you. Could you put this into context for us? How bad are Yemen's food shortages?
Thank you very much. The war in Yemen is occurring at a time when the population is already highly vulnerable to additional shocks. There are already high unemployment levels in the country. Up to 40% of the population estimated to require humanitarian assistance, as you said, is more than 10 million. So the war is currently causing human displacement, up to 1 million, a severe scarcity of food, fuel, due to direct and indirect impact of the war, disrupted livelihoods and incomes, because employment opportunities and labor opportunities have reduced due to the disruptions to industry, trade, transportation, agricultural activities, and so forth. There are very high prices. Rises in prices, for example, more than 100% rise in staple foods like wheat. Fuel is scarce, transportation costs are very high. Natural gas, which is used for cooking for most urban households, is very scarce and prices are very high. The conflict started at the beginning of the agriculture season, so it's disrupting the start of the season.
So clearly it has impacted on the infrastructure and, of course, the ability to harvest the crops. So in terms of bringing aid into the country, what are these strategic difficulties that organizations are facing?
The first one is that aid has to dock into the ports, and currently this has to be inspected and cleared by coalition forces. So the process is delaying, so that's one big problem. And once aid reaches the ports, it has to be distributed to the governorates, which are 22 governorates, and the districts. And access, basically transportation, is very difficult unless windows of transportation are created or corridors, safe corridors are created. So this is really the biggest difficulty, accessing the populations that are worst affected. And in areas where there's ground war, this is even worse.
Now, there was a brief lull in the Saudi-led airstrike so that aid could be brought into the country. Do we know how much of that assistance actually got through to the people?
Well, there was WFP managed to distribute some food that I don't have figures for because I don't work for that agency. However, there has been some aid that has been moved and been distributed in areas where there is no ground war. Especially, there has been a bit more better targeting, but in areas where there has been a ground war, especially in the southern governorates of Aden, Lahaj, Abyan, Dale, these places, and Taiz, these places have had a big difficulty receiving that aid because humanitarian access is very, very limited.
Would you say that it's mainly towns or cities or both that have been particularly affected?
It's mainly cities, but most of the districts that are in the governorates have the cities as their hub and their supply points. So the supply comes from the cities. So when you have Taiz, one of the biggest, highest populated city in the country, having a serious war, and it's the main entrance to all the districts, then the population in the rural area are indirectly affected by lack of supplies and lack of just transportation. So the cities, of course, bear the brunt of the immediate war, but the districts receive the displaced people. They already have limited resources, and that's where most of the rural poverty is. And now they're having almost a strangulation, especially in some of the areas that have seen the most serious ground fighting.
It's a very distressing situation. Are you concerned that perhaps Yemen will fall down the priority list as the world's attention is diverted elsewhere to other crises?
Well, there's always a risk of a crisis becoming not very interesting, but I think Yemen is currently on the priority list. The humanitarians, well, I'm not talking for the donors, of course, because as the humanitarian agencies and development agencies, we are doing every effort to make sure that Yemen is on the radar. We are producing reports. We are currently doing an analysis of the food security situation in using international approved methods, and we shall be releasing those reports, and we shall make sure that Yemen's plight is not off the radar.
Okay, Mohamed Suleiman, we'll leave it there, but thank you so much for joining us and updating us of the humanitarian situation in Yemen.